Did you know that your signal's amplitude and rise time could appear totally incorrect, and you may not even realize it? Forgetting about probe calibration is a common pitfall that is easy to correct and will save you from making critical measurement errors. Hi, I'm Melissa. In this episode of Probing Pitfalls, you'll learn about what problems uncalibrated probes can cause. We'll also look at how to solve these problems very easily with the oscilloscope's built-in probe calibration. Hooked up to my oscilloscope, I have two probes measuring my signal. This is what my signal looks like with an uncalibrated probe. At first glance, this looks okay. If I didn't know any better, I'd proceed with my measurements. On channel 3 in blue, this is the same measurement with a calibrated probe. Now you can see how far off my measurement would have been with the uncalibrated probe. Before we dive into probe calibration, let's take a look at the path your signal takes when you connect it to the oscilloscope so that we understand what is causing the skew. The original signal you see here is a representation of the signal that is actually in your DUT before you probe it. When you probe the DUT, the probe may add distortions to your signal. These distortions are caused by things like probe capacitance or inductance. The signal on the probe tip is then attenuated or amplified and sent to the oscilloscope input. And finally, the oscilloscope converts this analog signal to a digitized version using digital signal processing. Skew and amplitude changes can occur during this process, which can cause inaccurate measurements. Skew on a signal is basically a timing difference between rising edges. If a signal is skewed, this means the rising edge shown on the scope is delayed compared to when the rising edge truly occurs in your device. Along with these pesky timing differences, amplitude differences can occur as well, meaning your vertical measurements like peak-to-peak voltage will be incorrect. Not seeing a true representation of your DUT signal on the oscilloscope can make it difficult, if not impossible, for you to debug and complete your design work. The good news is that both vertical error and skew can be easily fixed simply by calibrating your probe. Probe calibration is easily forgotten, but it's an important step to ensure you make the most accurate measurement possible. The probe and the oscilloscope together are a measurement system, and that creates the signal path we discussed. Each probe's output and each oscilloscope's input characteristics will differ due to slight component variations. This is comparable to when you measure two 1-ohm resistors. Neither of them will be exactly 1 ohm, but they are within a tolerated range to meet their specification. You can take some of this variability out of the system by calibrating your probe to the oscilloscope input. This helps prevent major amplitude changes and skew errors. Keysight oscilloscopes can recognize Keysight active probes and give you a message on the screen if your probe is not calibrated to your oscilloscope. Let's take a look at what happens if you use uncalibrated probes. In yellow, we can see a 757 Hz clock signal before probing. This is being fed straight into the scope using a special de-skew device. Now I'm probing the signal with the uncalibrated probe, which we can see on channel 2 in green. The generator output on channel 1 is right around 520 millivolts peak to peak, and the probe signal on channel 2 is 550 millivolts peak to peak. In addition, the skew from channel 1 to channel 2 is massive, around 320 microseconds, which means the rise times don't line up at all. If this were a digital communication line, you might interpret this as misaligned data and clock lines, which is a design problem. But in reality, it's just your probe causing this error. Or if you're making a power measurement, having your current and voltage signals significantly skewed like this could leave you with dramatically incorrect power calculations. Uncalibrated probes can lead to a lot of confusion in many test scenarios, leading you to mistakenly think your design is flawed. Let's fix this issue by calibrating our probe. On my Infinium oscilloscope, I can go into the channel menu and see the probe calibration button, and we can walk through the amplitude and skew calibrations in less than 5 seconds each. The scope prompts you when the calibration is done. Now, if we make the same measurements we did before, we can see the results are much more accurate. The amplitude is improved by about 25 millivolts peak to peak, and the skew has been corrected. Both rise times line up so well that we can't even see channel 1. Now we are seeing the accurate representation of the signal. The amplitude calibration may not seem as drastic as the skew in this case, but when you're making critical measurements, a 10 millivolt difference can be a really big deal. So the signal path from your DUT to your probe and through your oscilloscope to the screen can cause errors in your measurements if the probe is not calibrated correctly. And it only takes a few seconds to calibrate your probe. That's time well spent to save hours of head scratching as you try to figure out what's wrong with your device. Always calibrate your probe with the oscilloscope channel you are using for the best fidelity in your measurement. Check out the link in the description to download application notes that can help you learn how to probe more effectively for your specific test. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more videos like this and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.